WPRI 1500 in Indianapolis.
The Martin Bender Band Sheridan Show.
Thank you, everybody, that signed up to the Clanging Gong News.
You people are crazy for doing that.
You took the challenge, and I got a lot of new signups. It's fantastic. Why not? It's a free newsletter, and it's fantastically packed with lots of information and satirical cartoons. I love satire. I love making fun of religious hypocrites. Well, Paul did.
Yeah, he did.
You know, everybody, time somebody says, you know, you're mean to people. I'm not. You know, people think this is... that an era of grace necessarily translates to an era of nice. But, you know, Paul says that we're to expose, rebuke, and entreat. We're to expose the falsehood. And one of the best ways to do that is by using satire.
Yeah.
Paul himself did it. I love how he called the circumcision the maimcision.
Maimcision.
That was a real play on words. In other words, you folks think that, you know, cutting the end off there is is going to make you right before God. He says, actually, you're only maiming the flesh.
Yeah.
You're only hurting yourself. You're injuring your body. He called him, he made it a play on words called the circumcision, the maimcision. That was bitter satire.
Uh-huh.
And in that same context, he says, would that you would cut yourselves off also.
Ooh.
you know what he's saying there?
Yeah.
If you think that cutting a little bit off is good, don't just cut the whole thing off. It'd be even better.
Yeah, exactly.
They should cut themselves off. This is the Apostle Paul, the messenger of grace. He's using satire to expose. This is what we do in the Clanging Gong News. Hello to Kelly in Arizona. Good to have you on board. Listen to us every day. And there's a guy who loads this show on his iPod as he bicycles to work in Holland. You can load this show. We want you to copy these shows. You can go to martinzetter.com, right-click, copy the show, load it onto a CD, put it in your car, on your iPod, take it with you. Have at it, folks. We want you to spread this word out there. I got an email from a guy. We talked about Israel, and I said that not even Israel comes into the truths of justification in the kingdom. And I dealt with this in one of the Clanging Gongs, and she felt that we were putting down Israel. It's like, well, how can you say that the body of Christ has a greater expectation, that while Israel is shepherding the nations on the earth in 1,000 years, the body of Christ is among the celestials dispensing grace to realms unseen, seated at the right hand of God? It is a higher calling,
yeah.
And it sounds like we're putting down Israel, and this is how it comes across to some people.
Well, that's first let me say people are always being offended. Right. First of all, get a grip. Calm down. Stop being. Everyone's always so offended. I'm offended.
It's not politically correct to say that
offended.
Israel. Well, Israel itself was offended.
Notice how they looked at that. What you just said, that we're putting Israel down. No, we're not. We never put Israel down once. God is going to fulfill every promise he made to Israel. As a matter of fact,
you and I
probably more than most give Israel a place. That let's put it this way. If I walked into the UN today, a UN meeting, I would get up and say, no matter what you do, Israel's going to rule every one of you with a rod of iron.
Yeah.
What would happen?
Nothing good.
No, I'd probably be shot and killed. But that's exactly what's going to happen in the coming eon. Israel is going to rule this world with a rod of iron.
And many churches have spiritualized that away, thinking that the body of Christ is somehow spiritual Israel. I hear this phrase all the time. The body of Christ is spiritual Israel. God could not fulfill his literal promises. All these promises of inheriting the earth, the meek shall inherit the earth, the kingdom, the Abrahamic covenant, Christ himself coming down to confirm the patriarchal promises. It's not going to happen. Israel disobeyed. It was too tough for God. So now he's, quote, spiritually, unquote, fulfills these promises in the body of Christ.
Yeah.
Not true.
Yeah. Doesn't take any faith to believe that nonsense.
And Israel, this is what she's looking for. I don't begrudge. I mean, she's going to be so content with her place in the kingdom, not to belittle Israel at all. And I need to bring this out. What is the purpose of Paul saying in Romans 11 that the nations coming in would provoke Israel to jealousy?
Yeah.
That whole jealousy issue answers that question. The fact that Israel is made jealous from Paul going to the nations tells you that he is giving the nations something far greater than Israel has. Else, why would they be jealous?
Exactly. So, but the point, more than the most important point regarding this whole thing, is that Jewish people are part of the body of Christ too, if they believe in Christ. This calling, this higher blessing, as it were, goes out to all nations.
Now, but when you say that, it means that an Israelite, now we know in the body of Christ,
yes,
there's neither Jew nor Greek.
Right.
That was not a message that Peter ever taught.
No, no.
Because that message is death knell to Israel, because
exactly,
there's 12 thrones, there's 12 tribes.
Yes.
So, if in Christ there's neither Jew nor Greek, so some Israelites believe Paul's message.
Yes.
At the moment they do, they pretty much revoke their Israelite identity, and they become identified with the body of Christ.
Exactly.
But when Paul's preaching this message, at the same time, Peter is in Israel, and
right,
is he embracing Paul's message? Is he a member of the body of Christ? Is he revoking his nationality to become identified with this new teaching by Paul? Is he?
No.
No, he's not.
As a matter of fact, Peter, that was the whole point of Galatians 1 and 2, if you read that, is they recognize that Paul was entrusted with the evangel to the uncircumcision, and Peter to that of the circumcision.
Galatians 2.
And so they had two different messages going on at that time.
Right, which was really it's just as confusing today, because there was a time where there was only one message. There was the gospel to the circumcision.
Yes.
The gospel to Israel. It was easy back then.
Yeah.
Because there was only one way. Either you were an Israelite and you embrace the message of the circumcision, that you would inherit the Abrahamic promises, or you were a member of the nations,